Did you know you can host a Blazor single-page application in Azure Storage as a static website and also take advantage of Azure CDN for improved global performance? Jeremy Lickness is here to show us how he moved an Angular app to Blazor and hosted in Azure for Pocket Change today on Azure Friday. Hey everyone, Donovan Brown here with another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Jeremy, and he's going to show us how to host Blazor applications inside of Azure. So first off, what is Blazor?
Blazor is amazing.
Okay.
Okay, yeah, that's all I have to say. It's something I resisted at first because I said, do we need another front-end web framework? And what Blazor does is it takes the .NET framework and using a technology called WebAssembly, which is basically a sandbox that's supported by all modern browsers, okay, including the phone.
Oh.
There's an implementation of .NET that will run on WebAssembly. So essentially what I can do is take .NET applications and run them in the browser without a plugin.
Or I can also stop writing JavaScript and in place write C# instead.
Exactly. That's why people love it. Two main drivers behind Blazor. Number one, I don't have to learn JavaScript or switch to a different language. I can use C# all the way. Hmm. Number two is I can leverage existing code that I've written and have that actually plug into the browser. And I can truly share code between the server and the client, which is something developers are looking for all the time.
Awesome. Yeah, because that was the same thing that drove me to Node, was that I could write JavaScript on the server and the client.
Right.
And now I can write C#. So we kind of like leveled the playing field there on which language you're actually going to want to go choose.
Exactly.
Got it. So, but I can also take these applications and I can host them inside of Azure, which is what we're here to talk about today.
Yeah, and right, that's actually one of the amazing things. So I took what was an existing JavaScript-based application, it was an Angular app, and I ported it to Blazor just so I could learn what Blazor was about. And of course, I got to a certain point where I said, you know what, I need to have this demo app up and running if I'm going to publish a blog post. People want to see the application.
Sure.
So I've got the application here, and it's a really just a simple health app that you can put in your gender, your height, your weight, and it uses some popular algorithms to show like target heart rate, et cetera. But what's really neat is that Anthony Chu wrote this actually right when it was first released, the fact that Azure Storage supports now static websites.
That's pretty cool.
And so his blog post walks through exactly how to take a Blazor app and publish it to a static website, which gives me tremendous benefits. It's not only easy and straightforward, it's as easy as uploading files, and you can do it as part of a deployment pipeline.
Sure.
But then you can also, on top of that, take advantage of the fact that you can put a CDN in front of it.
Right.
And that'll get it actually closer to the end users who are using your application.
Right, so now when you want to actually host a spa now, you don't have to spin up a VM or even an app service. You can literally just take a simple storage account, copy your files there, and then you're going to get a URL that people can hit to access that particular application. Okay, got it. And because Blazor is basically just another way to write a spa, we can use that same technology to host our Blazor apps just like we would our Node or Angular or React or whatever the case might be.
Right, exactly. The end result of Angular or React or Vue is you get a set of static assets that you serve up. Now, those will talk to a backend and the backend doesn't change, but with a Blazor, you get that same set of static assets. The only difference is those assets include DLLs that are actually pulled in and run inside of the browser.
Got it. And those DLLs that are going to be required, because like you said, it works on phones and it works on Mac, and that means those are going to be hosted on the storage account or also in a CDN to make them much easier for people all over the world to get access to.
Absolutely.
Got it. Show how this works.
Okay. First, I'm going to jump in just to show you a little bit of code. This is my Blazor app. If anyone writes ASP.NET MVC, it looks very similar, only this is code running in the browser. And what I'm pointing out here is just I have access to dependency injection.
Cool.
So I can say every time I ask for the model, give me the main model. I have a little height slider that this is using Razor templates. Again, these are the same templates that you would use in an MVC app.
Hmm.
Only in this case, because it's in a Blazor app, this is going to be rendered inside of the browser and executed on the client side. And I have straightforward C# code that's marshaling values back and forth. This is another control that's taking the model and outputting it. And that all results in this application that I showed here that, you know, I can move parameters around, I can play around with the weight, and everything just dynamically updates as a result of that. So as part of my build process, I get a set of assets that I want to host.
Right.
And this is a storage account that I created. And when I go into the storage account, I've got access to this option right here, static website.
Okay.
The first time I go into this option, it's going to be disabled. So I just simply click enabled, and it's going to give me an endpoint that we can just copy out and paste in to get the Blazor Health app. That's how I got to this one. It's just the same endpoint.
Okay.
And we also tell it basically what file is the default file to serve.
Fair
That's
enough.
The index. Now, what this does when you turn it on and you enable it is it creates this special blob container called $web. What $web does is it contains the actual assets for my project. So the index is what kicks everything off. The bootstrap is what starts to load pieces. And then if we go in this framework folder, we've got our Blazor server, our Blazor WebAssembly. We've got, this is the actual WebAssembly file. This is the .NET runtime in WebAssembly ready to execute in any browser. And then if we back up and we look at our bin directory, these are the actual DLLs that are hosted. So when I load this application, I can come here and open up my debug and open up the network, and I'm just going to refresh this. What you'll see is essentially DLLs loaded directly into the browser. It starts out by bootstrapping the .NET, and then all these DLLs are pulled in and executed.
Okay, so we were talking about, yeah, you don't have to write JavaScript anymore, but there's a lot of JavaScript in that folder. Was that generated for me?
That was generated for you.
Okay. That's
just to wire in, because WebAssembly needs to talk to the DOM, to the HTML DOM. So there's a little bit of JavaScript that wires up and kind of sets the hooks for those to communicate between each other. But once it loads that WASM file, that WebAssembly file, you're 100% .NET inside of the browser.
Great, but as a .NET developer, I'm not going to have to learn how to write the bootstrap JSON. I mean, JavaScript. That gets
written
for me. Got it.
Yeah, you do file, new, and publish, and it's all there for
you. It's unbelievable.
And then the other aspect of this is once it's hosted inside of this storage account, what I can do is come down here, and I've got another option, which is Azure CDN. And now what this is going to do for me is I've got storage accounts, maybe I have multiple storage accounts, but what I want to do is get these files and assets. We're downloading DLLs.
Sure.
So we want to cache them, we want it to be fast and give a good user experience. So by applying the CDN endpoint, and I can basically create new, pick my tier, and this is mapping right on top of that static website that it created for me. Mm-hmm. This will then allow those assets to be distributed so that if someone's in Australia, even though my app is hosted here on storage in the States, they're going to get a copy close to them and have that fast latency and that fast refresh when they access the website.
Right, so this is the same way of using a CDN for your images or your JavaScript files, right? You want that content close to the person consuming it as possible so that there's little latency over the network. And now what we're doing is enabling that exact same functionality for your Blazor applications.
Correct.
To a CDN, it's just a file that needs to be served. It really doesn't care what the file actually is.
Right.
Perfect. And I also noticed here it says custom domain as well. So if I wanted to go register my own fancy domain name, friendly name, I could actually go register that to the static site as well.
Right, yeah. It's not very user-friendly if all your website's in Azure websites.
Exactly.
So you can take Donovan Brown or how about the black shirt.
There you go.
And make that the custom domain.
Very, very cool. And what we in our little package there, we said, and you could just do this for pocket change, right?
Sure.
So is that accurate, and how do we look at it?
That is very accurate. So I'll preface it by saying that I love storage. I do a lot of experiments and host a lot of apps on my personal Azure account.
Okay.
And I don't have a huge budget to do that.
Sure.
So I use storage because storage is incredibly inexpensive. It's literally, I have one application that is geo-replicated storage. So I've got failover. If the West Coast slides into the ocean,
right.
I have a backup copy on the East Coast, and it still just costs me dollars a month.
Wow.
And this is the actual cost for hosting this Blazor application. Now, this is a demo application.
Sure.
But it is getting hits and views daily for that.
Okay.
And this is at the end of my billing cycle, and it's cost me less than a dime.
Right, so even if we were to go 10 times the traffic that you have today, we'd still be talking less than a dollar to host this app. All right, so this is really like a big proponent to go spa, right?
Exactly.
And you really want to start making your apps being able to be statically hosted, because the cost savings. Like, you have me thinking now, because I have a couple apps running right now. I'm thinking, wow, I'm definitely paying more than a couple dollars to host those apps every month. And you give me a lot to think about here. But this is really cool. Thanks for all, because I didn't even know what Blazor was until we agreed to talk about this, which is really exciting. So I'm glad to know about that. And the fact that I can host them for so cheap is just incredible. So thanks for coming and showing this to us.
My pleasure.
We are learning all about hosting your Blazor applications in Azure here on Azure Friday.